case, because we have to look at the first reading from Paul to Philippians and this gospel together. Jesus is not praising this man because of his being a dishonest person. He's praising him because while he may be worldly, he had foresight, right? He had vision to look ahead and plan and say, wow, I'm in trouble. My master's going to fire me. I better set myself up for the future, right? To plan for the future. And this is what Paul, the first reading, is saying, hey, think about every day that I'm made for God and God made me for heaven. And that's really where my true home is. As we say, our true home is in heaven. Paul writes that, that our citizenship is in heaven. And as wonderful and as awesome and great as that is, God has more, right? He says, not only that, but I'm going to transform you, right? I'm going to transform you, and when someday your body will be glorified like Jesus' body was on that Easter Sunday morning, right? And it'll be a body that will be spiritual, and it'll be, will transcend time and place, and it won't be subject to all the things that we deal with and the problems. You know, we won't have to worry about pandemics or anything like that. So this is the message. I think this is the message, whether we're children going to school or adults, we need to keep in mind that I'm made for God, God and made by God, and God has made me for heaven. And I should keep my eyes on God, on Jesus Christ all the time.
Having us one united in faith, let us now bring our needs before our God.
For the church, may the Holy Spirit continue to bless and guide the whole earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, amen.
For our leaders and all those with worldly power, may God make them wise and selfless stewards of his gifts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, holy Father.
and eternal God. For though you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is your gift. Since our praise are not to your brethren, we have brought it up for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs and angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, front of all holiness. Make holy the hour of this day to be prayed by sending down your spirit upon him like the due form, so that they will become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and gave it thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Peter said, "When our union with supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, 'Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have led us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Have the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. Blessed Saint Joseph, our spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. You may merit to be called into eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And so yes, amen. Come back to the light of the day. Hear this, Amen. Appear we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Let the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by this heavenly sacrament, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what you promised through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sorry for starting the Mass late. There was a change in the schedule which I'm not aware of, and maybe Lydia was not even aware of it. So sorry that we started this Mass late, okay? The Lord be with you.
Amen.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Also,
thanks, Lydia.